and welcome back to our house, Living with the Lindsays. So today I decided to make smothered steak. So I got the onion, some gravy. These are the seasonings I'm going to use for my steak, some accent, garlic powder, Dale's, and Montreal steak seasoning. I'm also making a potato, and I'm going to use oil. I already rinsed them off, but I'm going to use oil and salt because my husband likes to eat the skin. I don't, but he does. And I already got a pre-made salad. So I'm going to get my stand, and I'll be back. Okay, so I am back. And I am going to... All right, I'm back. Let me get louder. So I'm going to add some... A little bit of oil to my pan. Okay, a lot of oil to my pan. And some butter. Some butter, baby. Get that butt off that spoon. And while that's doing its thing, I'm gonna season the meat. So you don't have to clean beef because it's not, what is it called? It don't get salmonella and all that. Like some people, like you ever hear rare steaks, this might as well be raw. Sometimes my husband eats raw hamburgers, so disgusting to me. But that's his thing, not mine. I ain't about that life. This is the Dale's season. And these are ribeye steaks. I'm not going to use a lot of, so I'm kind of wiping it on each other. Or the pan. Because that stuff is very strong to me. Very strong. If you buy, only use a little. Alright, let me rip my hand off. And I got this on, oops, I thought I had it on medium. Want some accent on it. Some garlic powder. Some of this Montreal seasoning. Oh, and I have my potatoes in the oven already. Because I'm going to try to keep ours on medium. A medium, but Nelly ain't about that much, so she wants hers cooked completely. So I'm going to do a pouch, basically, like I did on the chicken and pork. A couple of videos back. That. No, I just forgot that if I had seasoned the other side, just that quick. Just that quick. Wash my hands. washing with soap. That's why it took me so long. One side of my skin not standing up. But I already put up my onion. I'm not gonna cook them all the way down because I'm gonna let them cook in the oven with my steak. I hope y'all can, because my stand is really acting a fool. While that's doing that, I'm going to get my pouch ready. What I call a pouch now. And then I'm gonna put it in the oven and check it in 10 minutes to see if it's medium, like how we like it. And if it's medium how I like it, then I know to cook Melissa's for like maybe 15 more minutes before it be done. Well, I'm cooking it 10 minutes on each side right now. They kind of thick, so I might, I'm gonna just do 10 minutes and see where I'm at then. So I'll be back. Okay, so my potatoes are done. This one's my old man's, this one mine. Make sure you always poke holes in your potatoes because you don't want them to explode in the oven. So, and I end up doing 5 minutes on each side. Bring out a little hem. Maybe if you can throw some. Looks like I'm gonna get my gravy. Use it all, use it all. Don't waste nothing. That's 34 cents worth of gravy. I'm gonna try to do 15 minutes because I did it 5 minutes on each side. So I'll be back in 15 minutes. Okay guys, this is the finished dinner. That's our ribeye, baked potato with some sour cream, a little salad, and that's it. On a serious note guys, I just want to talk about how people are going and shooting up these elementary schools, these concerts, these churches. I mean, I feel like it's psychotic. People say, oh, they're bipolar, they're this, they're that. No, that's psychotic. And some of it is on a racist note. When you go shoot up a black church or a synagogue, I mean, it's crazy. And they are, it's mental health. I know mental health. Maybe one day I'll do a video on it. But this level is just, at this point, it's psychotic. I feel like they just wake up and be like, oh, I want to be famous. And they're choosing the wrong way to be that. And it's sad. So, that's all I had to say. Is that I pray for the families and stuff like that. And, that's it. So, I guess I'll see you guys on the next one. Bye. Gotta stop it. Sorry.